Let us pray. Renewed by food from your heavenly table, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that by the power of this sacrifice, the soul of Father Tim Miller, your servant and priest, who faithfully ministered in your church, may exalt forever in your sight through Christ our Lord.
There are just a couple more announcements. Bishop Hoeppner asked if Father Tim was going to give you or me. I'll give it. There is lunch following afterwards. And we do ask that for the prayers of interment in the cemetery, given our recent snowfall, we're told that it's both messy and complicated to be out there. So we ask just the family to make the funeral procession and the prayers out of the cemetery. But all of your guests and friends, please do stay and enjoy the fellowship in the dining room immediately after our mass. And the family will be back as soon as possible to greet you and to enjoy your company. I'm also told that there are plenty more of those beautiful funeral photos in Father Tim's honor, and especially those who are from parishes Father Tim served, please stop at the guest book stand, and there will be plenty more for you to take home to those parishes as a memento for those that wouldn't have been able to make it today. And I'm pretty sure there was one more thing, and I'm not remembering it at the moment, so you know, I just might break in with that at any moment. So.
I know there are some who would love to have been here today but not up because of the weather, but Don Rodman, for example, called just before I came here to say that he could not come, or some of the religion could not come, but to give my regards to the family and from them, and so I do that. It's been into my fifth year now as your bishop, and one of the delights, many of them delights, in my years here is knowing Father Tim. I mean, you heard me tell the stories, whether it be about being called a wuss, or do I have a gun in the car? I've had many, many a good laugh, and many, many an enjoyable evening as he and Father Dan would come down for dinner on Tuesday night at my home. I was fortunate to receive the nudge of the Holy Spirit, I believe, that I would get to Fargo just hours before he died, to hold his hand once more and to look into those twinkling eyes. It was a wonderful few moments. The smile was there. I thanked him again for his presence and ministry among us, including even though the suffering and the offering up that he did for all of us. As he would undergo dialysis. The second to the last, the penultimate visit I had with him was not too long ago down in Fargo at Villa Marie, and I went to see him, and he was pedaling the treadmill or the bicycle, the exercise bicycle. I said, "Let's chat." And he said, "Fine, I'm going to keep pedaling." And the way I chatted. But we talked about how it was going and the daily offering that he had. Of his last days. So we thank Almighty God for his presence and ministry, and we commend him with our prayer. We know that his many, many good works accompany him now in faith. We say these last prayers. There are two things I would say during this commemoration now. We joined in 779 the Salve Regina. I know that the family sang that last night. And I asked that the priests, in a priest's funeral, as the casket has gone out, join in a small song from the Psalms. Oh, how good it is for brothers who love in unity, et shape on one. So you'll hear the priests break into that song just as we move out. Let us pray. Thank you. our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death.